is looking mighty fine if you're an Adelaide United fan and supporter. 3-1 at the halftime break as we entered the Hungry Jack's halftime show, and the Reds, they've looked dangerous. A little bit of a mistake from Trisha Vidakovic, the young goalkeeper who, of course, is filling in for Lawrence Thomas. A little bit to do for the Wanderers, though, as they head into this period. And I mentioned it is the Hungry Jack's halftime show. Bro, Donovan and Archie Thompson, your thoughts in total of what you've seen in the first half, team?
Yeah, well, Adelaide have been pretty dominant. I think Archie spoke about it before the game. Their press last week against Mariners was really good.
Yep.
But their structure, even sitting in a deep block today, they've really frustrated Wanderers. It's been terrific.
Yeah, and leading into this goal, Harps mentioned that maybe we're used to seeing Borrello put a bit more pressure on. But that ball was maybe moving a little bit, so maybe the keeper just kind of parried it because of that. But then Luka Jovanovic has been outstanding, following up as a good young striker should. And, you know, he tucked that away beautifully.
Absolutely. And, again, Adelaide comfortable. But this was a speculative cross, not much in it. Tristan Vidakovic, a young keeper, and, you know, it's hard to watch that for him. And, you know, he has to be strong now and forget about it and move forward, because it's a bad mistake and it's an easy tap-in for a UB in the end. And,
yeah, we thought at that time that Tristan Vidakovic was an own goal for him, as though he parried it into his own net. Austin Ayoubi was attributed the goal. Then this in response was a good response from the Wanderers. We thought, oh, this will get him off and going.
Yeah, definitely. I mean, it was a great finish there, and we did think that this was going to breathe a little bit of life back into this Western Sydney side, because they really started this game sluggish. And knowing too, off the back of last game for Adelaide United, how good they started, they really just didn't really come to the fore. And what about that for
a goal?
Unbelievable, yeah. That's goal of the week straight off the bat there. But, you know, great goal. Goalkeeper couldn't do much with that one. Dylan Piraeus, he really enjoyed that against his former club. But really, for me, Wanderers need to find a way to get Juan Mata on the ball. He's getting so frustrated.
Yes.
He's running around. He's demanding it. And they're not giving him the ball. So just give the people what they want. Give Juan Mata the ball and we'd have a game in the second half here.
Those were the Harvey Norman highlights. And this is a look at the Paramount Plus Player Index. You talk about Juan Mata. Dylan Piraeus sits top of the pops there. And he made a great save on Juan Mata when he got an opportunity in front of goal as well. And you've said it there, because give him the ball. Give him the ball. He's just asking for an opportunity to be played in. That's exactly what you want. We're up to a short break. We've got more coming up. What can the Wanderers do? What can they fashion at home at Combank Stadium? That was the Hungry Jack's halftime show. And don't forget the Alex Tobin Player at Prize for the best player across the season is back. It's a little bit different this year. Take a listen.
This year's Alex Tobin Medal is brought to you by Isuzu Ute. The winner of the prestigious award will win their choice of a brand new top-of-the-range Isuzu D-Max or 7-seat MUX. Plus, the Isuzu Ute Alex Tobin Medalist will nominate a junior football club to win $10,000. Make sure you're watching this season's grand final when the winning player and club will be revealed.